Early in the 20th century, the Wright brothers invented this basket-like contraption and confounded the critics by actually flying it. They little guessed what they were starting. They were not to know that, in our time, upon that fragile foundation, there would be built mighty machines such as this, capable of taking to an enemy hundreds of miles away loads of bombs weighing thousands of pounds. Such is progress. At the outbreak of the First World War, the Royal Flying Corps was in its infancy, while its sister service, the Royal Naval Air Service, was also only cutting its eye teeth. These Imperial War Museum pictures also bring back to the screen a few shots of the women, who, by their help in the workshops and on the aerodromes, helped to win the last war, just as their daughters are helping to win this one. Every girl in the service releases a man for a job better suited to his abilities. Other interesting contrasts are provided by bombs of those early days, terrifying as they were then, but which appear insignificant when compared with the huge and heavy bombs of today. From a few hundred pounders up to the 4,000 and 8,000 pounders which the RAF are dropping on Germany these days. Just a final glance back to a few of the planes of the last war. They played their part in the fight against the Kaiser and his hordes. Compare them with the magnificent machines with which the RAF is equipped as it comes to the ripe age of 25 years young. Thus we come to the month of April 1918, 25 years ago, when the Royal Flying Corps, the RFC, was welded to the Royal Naval Air Service, the RNAS, and the Royal Air Force came into being. The Royal Air Force, known to the whole world as the RAF, which today, on its 25th birthday, has a history without parallel. In the early days of the RAF, development of aircraft was rapid, so much so that in the Schneider Trophy contest of 1931, a speed of 379 miles an hour was achieved. 4 years later, at Milton Hall, His Majesty King George V reviewed what was then probably the biggest assembly of aeroplanes to date. The annual air pageants at Hendon made the man in the street more air-minded than ever. These displays thrilled us all with mass flights. Precision bombing was always a star item on the bill. In 1937, we learned quite a lot about parachutes in large numbers. In 1938, only a year or so before the outbreak of the present war, the first Spitfires made their bow in public. They were the forerunners, or should I say, foreflyers, of the Spitfires, which, with Hurricanes and Defiance, gave Goering's Luftwaffe such a terrible pounding in the Battle of Britain. It was of the men who flew these that Mr. Churchill in the House of Commons on the afternoon of August the 20th, 1940, uttered his famous tribute. Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few. Here are a few of the heroes who have helped to make the RAF the greatest air force in the world. Squadron Leader Nicholson, VC. Sergeant Hanna, VC. Sergeant Ward, VC. Squadron Leader Finucane, DSO, DFC and 2 bars, and Wing Commander Nettleton, VC. So we come to this year of grace 1943, when we celebrate the silver jubilee of the Royal Air Force. Within the limits of a newsreel, we can only touch upon a very few of its many activities. Of its fighter squadrons, we have already spoken. In addition, there are, of course, the other operational commands. Coastal, Army Cooperation, and Bomber, backed by the very important non-operational commands, all of which are playing star parts in the stern drama in which we and our allies are engaged. On all the seven seas and the five continents, our knights of the air are to be found fighting for our cause, patrolling, protecting convoys, attacking the enemy here, there, and everywhere. Never a pause in their work. One could almost imagine Staniforth was creating a motto for the Royal Air Force of today when he wrote, "Count that day lost, whose low descending sun views from this hand no worthy action done." Perhaps the branch of the RAF more in the public eye than any other at this time is Bomber Command, now engaged on an all-out offensive against our enemies. How they are attacking objectives in enemy-occupied and enemy territory has presented the screen with some of its most thrilling pictures taken during the biggest anti-Axis blitzes of all time. Some of the places they have visited are... We feel it is fitting to bring to a close our Silver Jubilee tribute to the gallant Royal Air Force with the time-honored wish, many happy returns.